Hello and welcome. I'm Raghav and today we are going to learn how to install JMeter on Mac operating system. And this is going to be very easy and I'm going very basic step by step. So step number one is check Java is installed on your system. So you can go to your terminal. I'm pressing command spacebar to bring on this spotlight search and I will say terminal and open the terminal app. And here on the terminal, you can just say Java space hyphen version and this will show you your Java version. Now just in case you are not getting the Java version, that means Java is either not installed or not set up properly on your system. So for that you can go to Google and search for how to install Java on Mac, and I have a video on this. So if you search by my name, you will get a video that I created on this, and you can see this is the video on how to install Java on Mac, and you can search for this. And I will also copy this link and provide it in my notes, and all these notes will be available for you, so you can check it from here in case you do not have. And the command is Java space hyphen version to check the Java version installed. Now step number two is download JMeter. So you will go to Google and here you can just search for download JMeter, and the very first option you will get is from jmeter.apache.org download. So I will go here, and here you can see we have the download releases page here. If you click here, you will go to this download Apache JMeter, and at the time of recording this video, the latest version is Apache JMeter 5.0 and it requires Java 8 or Java 9. So if you have Java 8 or 9, it is fine. You can use Apache JMeter 5.0, and if you have an older version of Java, you can upgrade your Java version. And in case you want to go with an older version of Java as well as JMeter, you can go down, come to this archives section, and here you can click on this Apache JMeter archives, go here, and here go to source, and you can get all the earlier versions of JMeter from here. So you can get an earlier version just in case you want, but it is always recommended to use the latest version of JMeter. So I will go back to the download page, and now you can get the JMeter from binaries section or from source section. However, there is a problem. If you get it from source section, the zip file, it does not contain Apache JMeter.jar file, which is required by JMeter. So you can get it from the binary section and click on this zip file. So it will start downloading the zip folder. Now I'm going to cancel this because I already have it, and let me just show you. I will go to my downloads page, downloads folder, and you can see I have this Apache JMeter 5.0.zip, and I have already unarchived it. And you can see the folder here. So I'm going to take this, I'm going to move it. So I will cut it from here, and let me go to my desktop and go to tools, and I'm going to create a new folder here. So you can place it wherever you want. You can place your JMeter folder, you can unzip and place it. So I have this JMeter folder already here. Let me create a new folder by the name JMeter 5. And inside this, I'm going to paste the Apache JMeter 5.0 folder that I have downloaded and unzipped. Now here, if you go inside this folder, you will find a folder called bin. And inside this bin folder, you will get all these files. And this is the file I was talking about, Apache JMeter.jar. This is not available if you get it from sources. There might be some issues, so you can get it from binaries. And then you should see a file called jmeter.sh. So you can use jmeter.sh or Apache jmeter.jar file to start JMeter. So here, let me also copy this URL. All these notes will be available for you. And now step number three is start JMeter. So for starting JMeter, what you will have to do is you have to go to the location of the bin folder. So this folder, right? So you have to go to this location. So if I just copy the location of this folder, or let me just say, I will go to my terminal and say, change the location to the folder bin, and it is located on desktop tools, JMeter 5, then we have Apache JMeter 5.0 and bin. So I'm on this location, and now I can say sh jmeter.sh. And run this, it will start our JMeter. So you can see it is starting. It is also giving us this message, don't use GUI mode for load testing, only use test creation and test debugging, and for load testing use non-GUI mode. So all this we will see later. But now it is starting our JMeter, and you can see our JMeter is up and running. And now we can start creating our test plan on JMeter. So to close JMeter, you can just go here and close, or you can press Ctrl+C on the terminal. And also you can start it using the Apache JMeter.jar file. And for that, you will have to say java-jar Apache JMeter.jar. And this will do the same thing. It will open our JMeter. And yes, our JMeter is starting. And yes, you can see our JMeter is up. So this is how you can start JMeter. And I hope this session was useful for you. In the coming session, we will go more deeply into JMeter. And I hope this all information was very useful for you. Thank you for watching.